Asamyuta Hasta, the single hand gestures. This video of single hand gestures is specially designed for the benefit of beginners. The way a gesture needs to be held and its meaning is also mentioned. Pataka. Here the thumb is bent to touch the fingers and the fingers are extended. This is pataka. And the meaning is a flag. Tripataka. When the ring finger is bent in a pataka hand, it becomes tripataka. And this denotes a flag with three colors. Artha pataka. When the ring finger and the little finger are bent, it then becomes artha pataka, which denotes half of a flag. Kartari Mukha. The index finger and the middle finger are outspread. This looks like a scissor, doesn't it? Mayurakyo. When we join the ring finger to the thumb and the other fingers are extended, then it is Mayura Hasta, depicting a peacock. Arthachandra. The thumb of the pataka hand is stretched out. It becomes Arthachandra. The meaning is half moon. Arala. When the index finger is curved to touch the thumb, it becomes Arala and it means bent. Shukatunda. In this hasta, we find the index finger and the ring finger curved to denote a parrot's head. Pushti. When all the four fingers are bent upon the palm and the thumb is set on them, then it becomes mushti and it means a fist. Shikhara. If the mushti hand has its thumb raised up, it becomes shikhara, depicting a peak. Kapitha. The index finger bends and rests upon the thumb. It is then called Kapitha, meaning elephant apple. Katakamukha. We need to rest the index finger and the middle finger on the thumb and the meaning is opening of a bracelet. Suchi. The index finger is raised and the rest of the fingers are pressed to the palm. This denotes a needle. Going forward, in the next mudra, maintain the suchi hand, releasing the thumb which makes Chandrakala, meaning digit of the moon. Padma Kosha. When the fingers are separated and a little bent and the palm is also a little hollowed, the hand is called Padma Kosha and the meaning is lotus bud. Sarpa Shirsha. In this hasta, the tips of the fingers in the pataka hand are bent, which looks like a snake's hood. Mruga Shirsha. When the thumb and the little fingers are extended and the three fingers in the middle are bent forward, it forms Mruga Shirsha, denoting a deer's head. Simha Mukha. The tips of the middle finger and the ring finger are applied to the thumb and the rest of the fingers are extended. This hand means a lion's face. Langula or Langula. Moving on, we need to hold Padma Kosha and tuck in the ring finger. It becomes Kangula, which looks like a bell. Alapadma. Here, the fingers beginning from the little finger are bent and separated from one another. The hand is called Alapadma, denoting a full-bloomed lotus. Chatura. Let's observe the next mudra carefully. The thumb is placed in the middle of the middle finger and the adjoining two fingers are clinging to the middle finger and the little finger is outstretched. It becomes chatura, meaning a square. Bhramara. When the thumb and the middle finger touch each other and the forefinger is curved and the remaining fingers are outstretched, the hand is called Bhramara, meaning a bee. Hamsasya. If the thumb and the forefinger touch each other and the remaining fingers are outstretched, the hand is called Hamsasya, denoting a swan beak. Hamsapaksha. If the little finger of the Sarpashirsha hand is outstretched, the hand is called Hamsapaksha, meaning swan's wing. Samdamsha. If the fingers of Padmakosha are closed and opened, then it is Samdamsha and it means pincers. Mukula. If we bring all the fingers of our hand to meet together, then it is called Mukula, meaning a flower bud. Tamrachuda. We need to curve the index finger and hold the rest of the fingers in a closed fashion. Then it becomes Tamrachuda, denoting a cock. Trishula. We need to hold the thumb and the little finger, stretching the middle three fingers upright as if to show number three. It denotes Trishula, the powerful weapon. Why don't you try now? Say the name, hold the hasta and practice.